Hi everyone, it's Ken LaRue from the Shotgun Team once again with our tip of the day for 30 tips in 30 days. Today's tip is aimed at the administrator, the manager, or the person who is going to be creating lots of shots, a lot of assets, sequences, and so on. Here we're looking at a new project, we're looking at the overview page, and no shots have been added, no assets, nothing has been added except for a couple artists have been invited to join the project. We want to add some elements, so I can go over to the add, the plus sign up here in the upper right corner, and you'll see a list of all the different things that we can create for our shotgun project. If I choose asset, we're going to receive the create a new asset form. We can add a name, and we have cancel and create asset. Let me cancel that. Let's go back to our plus sign. I'll come down and I'll choose new version. And then the create version form is going to appear. And I have options of dragging files in here, adding descriptions. And again, on the bottom, we have cancel and create version. I'm going to cancel that once again. If I go to any page, such as the asset page, you'll notice since we haven't created any assets, there's a link right here to create new assets. And then every page you go to also will have, depending on what it is, an asset, a task, a shot, and so on, you'll have a create new asset. Or if I go to the task page, same option, create new task. There's the create task button there. If I go to the shots page, same thing, create new shot and create new shot button there. I'm just trying to show you there are many different ways that you can create different elements inside a shotgun. But now I'm going to click where it reads create new shot. The create new shot form appears. It's asking me, first of all, to add a shot code. So I'm going to enter shot 001. And then I'll click create shot. The shot is created, it's added onto the shot page, and that form closes. Let's bring it back up though. So I'll go back over here where I see the plus sign and it reads shot. I click on it. Now, once again, the create new shot form appears. Look at the upper right corner of this form and you'll see the little gear icon. Clicking on this, you're going to see several different options to control the form. I can choose configure layout. We're not going to spend a lot of time on this. I just want to show it to you. Configure layout, and I can come in here and I can control the properties and what is displayed and so on. So I can customize the form for creating a shot. Now I have the ability to do this because I am the administrator and I have permissions to do this. But I'll choose cancel because, like I said, we're not going to spend time on that. That's not what I'm focusing this tip on. What I want to focus this tip on is how you can use these three options to help automate the process and fill in fields while you're creating a lot of these different elements, such as a shot. The default is close form on create. And when that is selected, the blue button below will read create shot. I'll choose this to reset form on create. And you'll notice that the blue button just changed to create shot and reset form. So what does that mean? Let's come in here and let's add another shot code. So I'll put shot 002 and I'll click create shot and reset form. You see in the background, my new shot was created, but my create new shot form remained open and it cleared the fields and the information that I had entered. Let's change it now from our gear to be keep form values and create. Now you'll notice the blue button reads create shot and keep form values. So let's come back in here, shot 003, and I click this. Notice this time the shot was created, but the shot code remained the same as it was a second ago. This allows me to come here very quickly, change it to 4, create shot, keep value, 4 is created, 5, click create shot, keep form. So you can see how with this option, I'm able to repurpose any information I've put into these fields inside of the form while I'm creating the shots. So these are great options that you have here. But what I find even more powerful is the ability to use modifier keys to access these three different options. So let me switch this back to close form on create, and then you'll see create shot is now available to me. If I hold the option key on the Mac or the alt key on Windows or Linux, you'll notice the create shot button switches to the create shot and keep form values. And if I hold option shift, you'll notice the blue button switches to create shot and reset form. On Windows and Linux, it is the Alt and the Shift key to access the create shot and reset form option. So now I'll release everything. I'm back to having the create shot, which is the which is the option of close form on create. So now I'll change my shot code. I'll hold the option key and click create shot and key form. It returns back to create shot, but I can then come in here and again, alter this, hold option, click this, and it goes back to create shot, the default setting. So it's a much faster way of accessing the different options I have in any one of the forms, no matter what you are creating. I'll come and change the shot code to 008. I'll hold option shift, and now I get the create shot reset form. I click that. You'll see the shot is created and added. The form stays open, but the fields are cleared. Now, a couple quick things I want to mention. If you have this set to reset form on create or keep form values on create, there is no modifier key to revert back to the close form on create. I can use shift option to switch over to create shot and reset form. But if I hold option or any hotkey combination, I don't switch back to the default close form on create. If it's set to reset form on create, and now the button reads create shot and reset form, I can hold the option or alt on Windows and Linux, and I can toggle between the two options as we said before. So once again, just to reiterate, there is no hotkey modifier to switch to the default create shot if you are set to reset form on create or keep form values on create. Lastly, let me bring up an artist logged into this same project to show you a couple things. Now, the artist is going to be limited to the different elements they can create. Very common in a production, we don't want the artist creating shots and creating assets, but they can create versions and they can create notes. So let me bring up the Create New Version dialog box. And the first thing you're going to notice is that there is no gear. They do not have access to it because we also don't want the artist to customize this form. That's not what their job is. That's what the administrator needs to do. But that doesn't mean the artist cannot take advantage of the modifier keys we just learned about. Even though the gear is not there and they cannot manually switch the options for what this dialog box, what this form is going to do, they can use the hotkeys of Option on Mac or Alt on Windows and Shift Option and Shift Alt on Windows to change between the different options. So that's our tip for today on using hotkeys and modifier keys to alter and change what's going to happen when you create a new element inside any of the forms. 30 tips in 30 days.